Hello everyone. So I have a new lyrical combo for you guys, and I have a tutorial to go with it as well. So not only can you watch it, but you are going to get to learn it along with me and hopefully do it yourself, which is really fun. So I would say that this is more of an intermediate advanced, maybe a little bit more advanced lyrical dance. There are no crazy tricks in it, but you definitely do need your technique for it, and it is a little bit more fast-paced than my typical lyrical dances, so I'll definitely get your heart rate going a little bit, but still has that feeling in there as well. So I chose this song that really kind of applies to what I'm feeling and what I think a lot of us are feeling right now. I'm gonna do the combo for you first, and then we'll go through the tutorial. Just know that my body and my technique is not where it used to be. I am definitely getting older and I can feel it. So when you're watching, there's definitely gonna be some things that you will be able to do better, I'm sure. Like getting your leg a little bit higher, maybe a few more turns in there. So totally up to you on that one, but I feel like you'll all be able to do it a little bit better. I obviously can't have any assistance with me right now, so it's just me. So hopefully you can learn just as good from me. So let's go ahead and watch the combo, and then I will walk you through the tutorial.
I wish I could fix it. I wish I knew what to say. But everything feels like a lie these days. Don't know how not to feel that way. But everyone feels like a liar these days. Don't know how not to feel that way.
Make sure you're sitting nice and tall here too. Again, don't be slumped over as you're reaching. Straighten that back and really reach, shoulders back. Good. Again, this is 5, 6. I am going to roll down as I pull my right leg up to passe. 7, 8. So, with this, I'm going to turn like this so you can see me a little bit better. You want to imagine that there is a string attached to your right toe and a string attached to your left hand right here. So that they are pulling together. So if I was moving my right hand, it would be pulling my left foot, if that makes sense. And all one movement, as you roll down, that arm and that leg are moving. So imagine that string is attached to your fingers and your toe. You slide it down 7, 8 to kick 1, 2. So this arm should be all the way back. And again, your leg might be a little bit further than mine. This is 1, 2. Bringing that leg down nice and straight. I'm gonna roll to my right, to the front. I'm flipping to my belly on 3, 4. Notice how both of my hands are here. So if I was here, I'm gonna roll to the front. I'm switching my arms. This is 3, 4. My hands come to the side of my chest. My right leg bends. I am pushing back on 5, 6. So again, let me just take that back for you so at least you can see that. So if I'm here on my belly, I was right here. My hands come to the side of my chest. My right foot comes up. I'm pushing my left leg stays straight. This is what it should look like right here in the air. This is 5, 6. Right hand comes to my chest. Left hand comes to my belly as I contract in. And that is on 7, 8. So you push back 5, 6. This is 7, 8. Good. So you kind of hold this for that 1, 2. So you come back. You have that 7, 8, 1, 2. You're going to throw your body to the right. Boom. So I don't know if you can see it in the mirror here. Hopefully you can. But my right leg is bent to my knee. And then my left leg is in the attitude back here. So kind of an awkward position here. Hopefully you can see that right there. Let me turn like this just in case. If you can't see my body, this, you can see me. That's what I look like in the mirror. Good. So you're here. Coming around, I'm pushing up. I'm rolling around. My right foot, I am now facing my right side. My right foot steps forward as I stand my body up. And there's going to be points in here too. I am giving you counts, but there are some really distinct moments in here where you really hit on that beat and you can really hear in the music too. So even though I'm giving you counts, go back, listen to the music, really pay attention to those beats because nothing drives me crazier if you're not on the beat, if you're not with the music. To me, it's more important that you're following along with the music than really you're listening to the counts. Sometimes we get in our head. That's usually why I don't like to use counts. I feel like we get in our head too much and we start counting and we're not actually listening to the music. And we're not moving with the music and the beats and what they're saying. So even though giving you counts, I really encourage you to go back, listen to the music, find those beats, watch where I was dancing, find those beats as well, okay? Sorry, I'll stop right now and keep going. All right, so we stood up here. Whew, that was 7, 8. Okay, so now we're here. I'm gonna skip back just a little bit. Hopefully you can still see me in that mirror. I stood up. This is right into an arabesque, 1, 2. Standing leg is bent here, okay? Make sure your chest is up, back leg kicks right here, arms extend out, this is 1, 2. I step back on my left foot, right leg comes to passe, and I just swing my arms back. So my left leg stays straight as I'm coming into that passe, and you wanna really lean your body back into that. Sometimes when I was doing this, my arms would just kind of swing here, if you can see my right hand in front. I didn't want to go forward, my arms would go right. So kind of let that be your moment right there, wherever you feel those arms, where it takes you, let it take you there. Just make sure though that you are using your legs and your chest is leaning back into that. Make sure that this back leg stays straight though, okay? So swing, that's 3, 4. You step 5, 6. You're prepping here, my left foot is forward, I'm gonna do an inside turn. So again, we stood up, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, step 5, 6. Left foot is forward, back leg is straight. This is gonna be your inside turn right here. So again, yours is definitely gonna be better than mine. inside turn, going towards your left, okay? Going towards your left. Oh, I don't even know what I'm gonna look like right now. But okay, yours will be better. So inside turn here. You are facing that diagonal, okay? So make sure that when you're prepping for this inside turn, you are facing that right diagonal. Perfect, you turn. Good, nice and strong. You're in that relevé on that turn. You want to turn all the way around. As you stop to face this corner, your heel is going to come down into a plie, okay? This is how you stop. So find that spot. Really make sure your spot is so that when you come around out of that turn, it's in a relevé plie here to relevé, kick that right leg, boom, okay? And that kick is on 1-2. So we prepped. This is 5-6. You turn 7-8-1-2. Perfect. My right leg steps across over in front. I'm coming into a relevé, passe, arm swing. That is a relevé, okay? That is a relevé. So out of that relevé, up, my arms swing over. So out of that kick, steps across, 3-4. I'm stepping into my turn here, arms up, 5-6. You know what, I'm gonna be honest. I think it's on 7-8 that you drop again. This is a really distinct part where there's that beat and you drop yourself down. I'm a mess these days, guys. But out of that, sorry. You turn, you're gonna drop. And this is kind of a freedom moment right here, wherever your arms want to take you. So you definitely want to pull your body down. My hand is naturally pulled on my head, pull on my stomach. This is kind of a moment to really just feel it. But you want to make sure, out of that turn, this is the turn, and get nice and deep and low in that plie. So here, you should be pretty low right about here. And again, maybe your arms wrap your chest and pull your body down. Maybe both your hands pull your head and pull down. I kind of did this right here. I was about right here for this. Good. Boom. You're going to hear that big boom in the music. That's where you drop. Boom. Good. You're going to come up. She's going to say feel. So now we're going to move into lyrics right here. I'm going to give you lyrics. She's going to say, I don't know how to feel that way. I think that's what she says, but I know how to feel. So now we're gonna turn to the left diagonal. So you're right here. You're gonna pull up. My right foot is coming forward and grabbing my leg right here. So as you can see, my left leg is bent, okay? Right foot is flexed, knee is bent, and I'm holding the back of my thigh here. Okay, and I'm really pulling that leg in. So she says, I don't know how to feel, is when you wanna pull that leg in. Good, from here. And this kind of makes it a little bit easier. You can kind of pull your leg up with this. So you can kind of cheat it a little bit. So you're here. Both legs are bent. I'm going to pull that leg in as I point that toe. And I'll fan it around. So it's kind of nice. Hang your hands. Pull that leg in towards you. Get it up. Point that foot as it's coming around. So out of that second position, you're pulling your body down. You pull up. Don't know how to feel that. Pull it around. And that's in relevé too, okay? Pull that leg in, let it fan around. Again, this is kind of a free moment coming out of this. You fan that leg around. You're walking around yourself. Your arms can kind of be wherever you feel it. Mine were kind of coming here. I was pulling myself in, but I'm coming around my body, around my right shoulder, and now I'm walking towards the left diagonal. Perfect. And I stop with my right foot forward, left foot is tongue back, and I'm reaching my right arm forward here. Perfect. On this, music starts to pick up. You can hear it. Do, 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 do. I know it sounds easy. So you're right here. So you're going to step left, right, left, and you're going to go into your surprise beat, which brings your right foot forward. Boom. Okay? So, again, my leap is low. Yours can be a lot higher on that leap, okay? So, we're here. I'm sorry. We're here. I'm losing my mind. It is left, right, left, leap. Your leap is when she says me. On the word me is when you should have that leap. And if you're counting, it is 1, 2, 3. on 3, 4. Oh, I'm sorry. This is 5, 6, 7, kick 8. And that is in releve. That kick is in releve. 7, 8. You're going to land to turn 1, 2. So out of that kick, you land 1, pivot 2. Okay, so my left leg is back now. I'm facing directly to that right side. My right arm reaches 3, left arm 4. Good, big reach here too. The bigger the better. Open those hands, really reach, almost as if you're reaching for somebody that you can't get to and you really want them, which I feel like you can all feel that right now. So, you're reaching right here. Hands come to my head. As my hands come to my head, it body rolls me back. Okay, and that's on 5, 6, body roll. So this is 3, 4. 5, 6, step back, right, left. And that's 7, 8. Your head comes down, 7, 8. So out of that kick, you're just gonna back it up again. Out of that kick, that is 7, 8. You land a pivot, 1, 2. This is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And obviously it's a little bit faster. I'm just slowing it down right now for you so you have that. So from here, 7, 8. I'm going to pivot my body onto my left foot and wrap my hip on my chest. 1, 2. I'm going to barrel roll around. So with my barrel roll, I'm going over my right shoulder and my right leg is coming up first, okay? So I'm right here. So it's right, then the left. Okay, just to show you slow. Again, this is another moment where your legs can be higher. You can get that arch probably a little bit better than me, but just to show you. So here you're on 7, 8. This is 1, 2, up, 3, 4. Whew. I know that wasn't good, so make your tire. Get that arch back in that. Get those feet back, okay? Right, left. Get that arch back in there. Good, we land here. I got distracted, sorry. That is 3, 4, 5, 6. You pull your legs together. My forearms are gonna cover my face on 7, 8. So, you can see me here. I really wanna show you what this looks like. My hands are open. Good. And you really want your forearms, I'm almost looking down, just slightly. And you really want your forearms to be right here at your forehead and your eyes. Really let it cover here. So if you just barrel roll out of this, you just pull straight up, 7, 8. I'm gonna step onto my right foot. Left foot goes to an active, and I swing right. 1, 2. Again. 7, 8, this is 1, 2, and I'm looking to the right as I swing. Bottom leg is bent, foot is flat. I step to the left, 3, 4. Sorry, I back up just a little bit so you can see me. This is 1, 2, this is 3, 4. Let me make it up, sorry. This is what it's really like when I teach you, it's like all over the place. Sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, you step back. 5, 6, arms open, 7, 8. And my hands are pushing out. Woo! Are you following along with me? Even though I'm a mess? Okay. I am going to take you back here. 7, 8. You step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, both of my legs are straight, by the way. Push your chest out. Push those hands out. This should be nice and strong. Almost like there's a beam of light on your chest here and it's beaming up to the ceiling here. Good. So boom. 7, 8. This is 1. I'm going to plie. My arms wrapping my chest. 1. I drop down to a second position. 2. Again, nice and low for this plie, okay? So straight after this, this is 1. Drop 2. This is 3. 4. Hands are flexed, and I'm almost leaning a little bit into that. And you want to really push your hand. Look where you're pushing. 3, 4. Swing, bring your right leg towards your left. Legs together, my arms swing to the left. 5, 6. Okay? Back that up for just a second. You were here. 7, 8. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Swing 5. Ooh, and that's the runway, sorry. Swing 5, 6. You're gonna step right, left. So I'm in a little lunge right here as my right arm arm reaches forward. Okay, that's your 7-8. So, back it up just one more time, just to make sure you got it here. Again, you can always pause it and rewind it if you need to see it again. But we are here on 7-8. This is 1, 2, reach 3, 4, up 5, 6, step 7-8. We're so close, we're almost there, we're almost there. Perfect, so we're gonna pivot our body now to turn to this back diagonal. As we do that, it's coming through a little coupe here, and then I'm extending my leg out as I hinge my upper body back. Left leg stays bent, and it's here. So, to show you nice and slow, I pivot my body coming through coupe, and extend, boom. And again, you might be able to get your back a little bit further, you might be able to get a little bit deeper hinge in that, but make sure that this left leg stays bent, and you're really reaching those arms as you hinge back. And this leg is low. This is not a high kick right here. This is just a nice little 45 degree angle right here. And I'm facing that back diagonal with that. So if you're reaching here on 7-8, this is 1, 2, boom. Okay? Out of this, you step 3, 4. You're coming here, you're stepping on this. This should be in a releve. This is 5, 6. So, another moment, try to get as low into that planche as you can. You want to keep that releve, both legs are straight, and you want to really think of pushing this chest out and pushing these arms back. You should be looking directly forward as you're coming into that. So if you're out of this, woo! 1, 2, you step 3, 4, this is 5, 6. I'm going to show you slow. I'm coming down. It's kind of hard to show you this slow, but if I'm here, I'm tucking my legs under, my left leg is tucking under here, as you can see, and I'm rolling this way. Now I'm facing the left, my knees are bent. Perfect, so those counts if you're with that. Is 1, 2, you step 3, 4. This is 5, 6, you roll 7, 8, 1, 2. You reach your left arm 3, 4, my right hand is on the ground behind my legs. My left hand is going to pull my shoulder as I push my hips up. And just so you know, that is happening when she says shoulder. I think she says, I'll be a shoulder, something, something. But she says shoulder, so you know. Just to make that clear. So, you roll here, your arm reaches 3, 4. You push those hips up, left hand is to your shoulder, and try to look here at your shoulder, okay, following her hand. Hand touches that shoulder when she says shoulder. Bring that hand down, your booty comes down to the ground right here. Right leg is going to lift up. Extend it slow, it's not a kick, okay? Extend it, my hips are off the ground. From here, I'm going to push my hips up even further as I lower that right leg to the ground, my head comes all the way back. Now my body is nice and lined over here. From here, I'm going to gently slide it out. It's a gentle slide right here. You're not going all the way to the ground. It's just a small slide. I'm pushing here, and I reach, boom, to the left. And this is kind of up to you where you want to land with your legs. This is where my legs land. But you want that reach, boom, to be your really strong finish right there. I'm going to back it up just a little bit for you. Come over here just in case. I was not in the frame for that. If you cannot see me, because I got a little far over there. So I'm going to take it from right here, just in case if you couldn't see me. So we're in that releve planche right here. On that 5-6. This is 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2. Reach 3, 4. Shoulder 5, 6. Down 7, 8. This is up. 2. Move 3, 4. Slide it 5, 6, 7, 8. And that is your end. And you did it. So, again, I kind of went through that a little bit faster than I would in my classes, just so you could kind of be able to rewind it and pause it. Hopefully you were able to get that. If you guys have questions, if you really are trying this, and you have questions, let me know. Put comments down there or message me, whatever you like. Let me know if there's a certain part. But as you're doing this, I tell all my classes, make sure that you're adding that feeling into it. This is a really good feeling dance, especially with everything that she's saying in this too. So use those moments, milk those moments when we're in that second, you're pulling your head down, really feel that. Those moments where you're just walking around your shoulder and we're walking to that diagonal to reach, really reach like you're reaching for somebody that you want to get to and you can't. Always have this story for yourself when you're doing these dances. It's just gonna really bring out that life in it a little bit more. So if you can, just reach. Have all those moments. Don't rush it. Even though it's a little bit faster pace than kind of the slower lyricals that I do, don't rush it. Listen to the music. Milk those moments when you can, but listen to the music when you need to speed it up. So I hope that you guys were able to follow along. I hope that you guys get to try it. I would love to see if you guys are doing this. But thank you guys so much. I hope you enjoyed that, and I will try to get another one out to you guys soon.